Welcome to my YouTube channel. So we went driving and out and about visiting my younger daughter, and of course we couldn't resist going into a secondhand shop. So I'm going to share you some footage of the secondhand shop that is in a smallish kind of town. And I mean, this shop had everything that you can think of. So it took me just under 10 minutes to walk through just to take a video of not even everything. It's one of those shops you can go in 5 times and every time discover something new. I'm standing here with one of my favorite plants. It nearly looks like the same color as what I'm wearing. And then also doing things for my neighbors. I've done, what can I say, one thing, but they didn't ask me to do it, just out of my own. And then also whenever I go around the block, I always take a little bag and a plastic glove, and I collect all the rubbish that has fallen out after dustbin day. And I've got a photo of that, so I'll show you what the kind of thing is that I do. Anyways, keep well, enjoy your week further, bye. Here is the picture of the bag, the roll of bag, and the plastic glove. I take one bag and I take the glove, and then when I'm finished walking around my neighborhood or around the block, I put the plastic glove in the bag and then I discard it in my black dustbin. So this is what I show you here, and I buy both of those at Plastics for Africa. So today when I went walking around the block, this is what I found: a big bag full and a 2-liter milk bottle without the lid. So you can see it's necessary to do these kind of things in your environment just to keep it clean. So as I mentioned, we went for a drive out to my daughter, and it was so beautiful. These yellow pieces of felt was everywhere. I think it's canola, if I'm not mistaken. And it would just pop up when you were driving, you wondered how it was going to look over the next hill. So I'm just taking a few minutes of footage here for you guys to show you just how beautiful it looked with the yellow, and in between the wheat was green, and then the mountains in the background and the lovely blue sky. So yeah, you can see it's my husband driving, so I had time to take a video. And going up the hill, and there we go, boom, very yellow. So the sun made it very bright, and it looked like a lot of tracks in there, like tractors were driving in there, but it was just beautiful. So and then the next clip is me talking in the secondhand shop. There's a bit of a loud noise in the beginning. Okay, so here I am in Caledon at their secondhand shop. So I'm gonna go in and try to show you guys what a secondhand shop looks like. I've already put these candlesticks one side for me, as you know, I'm collecting. This is the upper amount that I like to pay, 15 rand, but it's very nice wood. And then a little boat for my dad. So that is so far what I'm buying. But you can see all the goodies in here. I mean, it's so fascinating to see. There is some antique tingy keys at the bottom. No, it's okay, you can come past. And look in here, also cutlery and things. And then over there, oh, so now the thing starts all the way to the back. This has got a lot of stuff, and they tried to section it. So I'm gonna go electronics, which I'm not really into, and then some leather stuff over here, some pants. I'm gonna try and go slowly for you guys so you can see. Hey, there's a dartboard, but it doesn't look like a real dartboard. Also, there's pictures all around the top. You can see all the way up and around. CDs. There's some tiles. Look at this cute little picture. But that picture is 290 rand. Right. We go back to this side where it was. There's a stove, and there was this guitar, but I mean, they want 290 rand for this guitar. It's got no strings, it's got no top, it's in a quite a bad state. I would maybe take it if it was 50 rand. Okay, here we go into this section, which is not really my interest. It's all kind of woodwork stuff. Beautiful windows. I mean, look at that beautiful arch window up there. And those kind of window things all the way through. Doors, windows. I'll take a good walk through here. There's a heap of clothes lying here. There's some window doors that is already been painted on. This is a nice color door that's here. And all gadgets and things to do with tires. Up there, hose pipes, more old windows all the way through. Bicycles, some planks, some steel things over here. Here is a fridge. Now I'm back here, there's another fridge. I'm gonna go around from where I came. Right, so I came from here. And I'm gonna go this side. Right, this side seems like a lot of tools. I'm also interested in old tools and things. Look at the drill bits and the pieces. Hey, look at this. If it's something with a handle like that, then I'm always interested. What is this? Interesting handle. What is that price? 18 rand? Okay. And then lots of little pieces. I mean, there is so much stuff here. You could look for days and still find something you haven't seen before. Brackets, light fittings, tools, scissors, pipes, lights, dusters, coasters. Hello, yes, I am in the shop with my mask on. All right, and then we've got chairs. Oh, look at these chairs with their legs. Pretty. I think I'm going too fast. There's a leather bag, some shoes, more shoes. I mean, these shoes look brand new. Tables, chairs, and I mean, look on these things, so pretty. Right, and here's a whole section. More guys, this is going to be too long a video, so I think I'll just have to show you. Oh, this is quite pretty, but it's 70 rand for one. A little bit too much for me. There's a fish at the back too. Ooh. That is very pretty. And then these sets over here, look how nice that is. Crockery. And this way, more stuff, more things over there. But yeah, dining room chairs. What's that? It's like filter paper balls. Another benches here. Oh, this is good. Right, there's just too many things to show you. Some glass stuff, dome things at the top, glass stuff at the bottom, copper things. And then this is, there's the radio playing in the background. This is all the wooden stuff, like African things.
And on the road is now traffic queuing in Somerset West on the N2 eastbound toward Victoria Street. Roadworks on the N2 east in Sellers Pass. The right lane will be closed there before the pickup hold. The N7 checks travel south, queuing at 4 Stacker and in N1
inbound. Slow traffic to toward the Okavango Road exit.
Queuing in Milton, traffic proof east of the N7 highway. Montague Drive south is heavy, and that's toward Bosman's Drive.
And then this corner. Like coffee machines, lights, and plastic things over here, and have to squeeze through here. Oh, my bag is a bit big. Oh, okay, I'm through. All kind of ceramics. This looks like toys. There's a clock for 40 rand, display only. Okay, that's not badly priced. And then, look at this old toy. It says it's a three-piece for 390 rand and an ox wagon thingy. Okay. All silver stuff here. Tammy, I found a thing for with 10 window, with 10 things.
I'm gonna buy these for Shania.
Does she need it?
Oh, have one.
Oh, that's nice for the soups. Just see if it fits. How much is it?
It's 165.
I think that's cheaper. Yeah, and clicks.
It's a good one over there.
Is it?
But
crockery, glasses. Oh my word. Then you get all your wires. This is a paradise for people that want to see a lot of things. You can see a lot of things. My eyes are kaput. What's this? Like a bottom of a 50 rand. Okay. Oh, this is cute. What is it? 290 rand. Looks like glass. And there's a bit of books here. There's a cupboard. Things up there. African things. Crutches. There's crutches. There's some pictures. More wooden things. I'm not too fond of clowns, but look, this is Allied Bank. That's an old thing. Everywhere. 9 minutes already, guys, and I haven't gone through the shop yet. Okay, peep peep, I need to
Mommy,
go
look at this though. Somebody gave all
yes.
their photos away.
If somebody gave all their photos away, their whole
their
life's
boats.
Worth of photos, full of little racks of it. Look at that. Okay, I need to come back. Right, and
that's
all labeled.
Though.
Look at all this. They've labeled it. What day? July 1966 to July, and they've labeled every single photo what is on the photo. And look at that. That's what you can buy at secondhand shops. Look at that big thing over there. What do you call it? And then there's a lot of just jars. Why would I buy a jar for 10 rand? Just drink the coffee and then I have the jar. Okay, and then boots. Cupboard here. Guys, this stuff is all over the place, and then outside is more stuff over there, and more stuff here, and more stuff there, and more stuff there. Sure, it's never ending. Okay, I'm gonna stop it here because I think I'm through the shop. Let me just show you something interesting to end up with. What should I show you? This little thing.
What is it?
A little face on top of a little sugar jar. Okay, guys. Once again, coming back home. Now you can see the sun has already started setting. The fields were more on my side of the car. There's a bit of a bug or something on the window, I see. And you can see it's not as bright yellow as when it was when we went. So coming back. But the colouring of the mountains and the field was very beautiful. There was also a lot of sheep around and the sheep would really looked very fat, and a lot of them had twin babies. So I thought that was very nice to include all the sheep. We saw them, a lot of them. You can see the background there with that mountain, the colouring of it looks like purpley. And the sheep, yeah, we do like lamb chops, so I'm not a vegetarian. And then we went over the mountain pass, and this is the view with a little bit of the sunset coming down Solari's Pass. I'm sorry about the side of the, but I tried to go as high as possible to show you that beautiful view as we came home with the false by laying there in the background. Anyways, catch you next time. Bye.